Hello all, in this video we will see finite automata with epsilon transitions. If you remember, epsilon is nothing but a null string. So epsilon transition means even without any input you can move from one state to another state. So that is, it's not possible in case of DFA, but it is possible with an NFA, and that kind of NFA is known as an epsilon NFA. So here again the tuple for epsilon NFA will be the same. It contain Q, sigma, delta, Q0 and A, the set of accepting states. Here the Q is a set of states, epsilon is the sigma is the set of input samples, delta is the transition function, Q0 is the start state, A is the set of accepting state. So this is exactly same as that of NFA and DFA. The only difference is the transition function can take as its arguments any state and any simple from sigma union epsilon. Okay, that is, here epsilon can also act as an input symbol. That is, even without giving any input you can move from one state to another. So again, one thing that I want to tell you is that epsilon NFA and NFA without epsilon has the same computational capability. That is, both of them are exactly same in case of power, and you can also convert an epsilon NFA into NFA or directly an epsilon NFA into DFA. That is, both DFA, NFA and epsilon NFA have the same computational power. None of them is stronger than the other, or none of them is weaker than the other two. Okay, both of them have the exactly same processing power, but the difference is in some case drawing epsilon NFA will be pretty much easier compared to drawing these two, and in some cases drawing NFA will be much easier than drawing the DFA. That's the only difference. That is why we have all these things. Okay, so I'll show you an example where drawing an epsilon NFA is much easy. Okay, so I'll give you a question. You may try to draw the DFA and NFA for that first. So you may try to draw the NFA for that. The question is, design an automata that accepts strings containing any number of zeros followed by any number of ones followed by any number of twos. So writing it and using a mathematical notation, zero star, that is, you can have any number of zeros including zero. So star means, as I have told you, zero or more occurrence. So zero or more zeros followed by zero or more ones followed by zero or more twos. Okay, you can have zero zero, even then that automata should accept it. You can have 10 lakh zeros, even then the automata should accept it. Then followed by that, you should have 0 or any number of 1s, followed by that 0 or any number of 2s. Okay, try to draw an NFA for this. Okay, so take your time to draw that. Meanwhile, I'll show you how to draw an epsilon NFA for this. So any number of zeros, isn't it? So Q0. So any number of zeros. Zero. Okay. So any number of zeros is accepted. Now followed by that, any number of ones including zero ones. Okay. And followed by that, any number of, you don't have to give it even double circles. We can make the design even simpler. Now, any number of ones followed by that, any number of twos. is just of one final state. So any number of zeros followed by any number of ones followed by any number of twos. See, even if you don't have any zero, epsilon will take you to q1. Even if you don't have any one, epsilon will take you to q2. Okay, so an null string is also acceptable because a null string contains no zeros, no ones, zero zeros, zero ones, and zero twos, isn't it? That will be accepted using this path. Now, any number of zeros, any number of ones, and any number of twos will be accepted. So this is the design wherein a string like 0, 1, 0, 1, 2 will not be accepted, because first is a set of zeros, then comes a set of ones, then comes a set of twos. No mixing is allowed. Of mixing of this binary letters is not allowed. First it should be some zeros, then it should be some ones, and then it should be some twos. Okay. Once the ones are started to come, you can't have any more zeros. Once the twos has started to appear, you can't have any more zeros or ones. So that is the pattern. Now this is the epsilon NFA. That is, drawing, designing epsilon NFA is pretty easy for this example. So what I want to tell you is that there are loads of designing examples wherein an epsilon NFA is the simplest one to draw. So that is the relevance of having epsilon NFA. Now don't worry, we can always convert an epsilon NFA into NFA and DFA. Okay. So this is the this is an example. We will see more examples. Next, we will draw NFA for a epsilon NFA for a floating point number. We are accepting numbers like plus O minus 43.73, like this. Okay. So initially it can be plus or minus. Even if there are no plus or minus at the beginning, we can assume that that is a positive number, isn't it? So Q0, you can have a plus, you can have a minus, and even if you don't have plus or minus, that is fine. Because for positive numbers, we don't usually put the plus, isn't it? So epsilon, that is, even when you don't have plus or minus, that is fine. You can move from this state to this state using this epsilon, that is using nothing. Okay. Now Q1. Now here you should have a number. Okay. Or it is okay if you don't have any number, because you can have plus or minus 0.73, isn't it? So it is okay not to have any number. But if you're having numbers, you can have the digits here. Okay, any number of digits can be here. Alright. Now, if it is, as it is a floating point number, you will definitely have a dot here. Then followed by the decimal point, you should have at least one number, one digit, isn't it? Otherwise, that doesn't make any sense. So Q2, you should have at least one digit. Now Q3, you can have any number of digits. So the number plus 43.75 will be accepted. Having nothing here, 4.73 will be accepted. Having nothing here, 0.73 will be accepted. Yeah, anything will be accepted. So this is the epsilon NFA for a floating point number. Write 0.0 to 9 instead of digit. Okay. You want, you can write 0 to 9 instead of writing digits. So now we will see what exactly is epsilon closure of a particular state in an epsilon NFA, because we need epsilon closure to find extended transition functions and also for converting epsilon NFA into NFAs and DFAs. Okay, so epsilon closure is very important. So I'll tell you how to define epsilon closure of a state Q. For example, if assume that epsilon state is Q, the state that we're considering is 1. See, so epsilon closure of a state Q contains Q itself. So epsilon closure of the state Q contains the same state itself, because from that state to that state, we don't need require any string, isn't it? That is saying another, speaking another words from one of your applying no input, you can state one itself, isn't it? So that is from one to one, you can move on epsilon transitions. So if one is the state that we are considering, one is in the epsilon closure of one. That is, any state will be in epsilon closure of itself. Now, if P is in epsilon closure of Q, then if there exists a transition from P to some state R on epsilon, then R also is there in epsilon closure of Q. Okay. Now I'll explain this with the help of an example. We will find epsilon closure. We'll write E close of 1 here. See, going by the 1 is this particular state. Going by the definition, epsilon closure of Q contains Q itself. So epsilon closure of 1 contains the state 1 itself, because from 1 to 1 you need nothing. That is, from 1 to 1 you can move on epsilon. So epsilon closure of 1 contains 1 itself, because epsilon closure of Q contains Q itself. Now yeah, from 1, that is, we will take 1 as P. If there is epsilon closure of Q, if P is in, so if P is in epsilon closure of Q, now that is 1 is in epsilon closure of Q, then 1, then there exists a path from 1 to 2 on epsilon, isn't it? So 2 also becomes the epsilon closure of 1. Okay, now there is a path from 1 to 4 only based on epsilon. So you can add 4 also to the epsilon closure of 1. Now this is a P. Now from this P to some state R, which is 3, there is a path based on epsilon. So you can add that also. That is the relevance of second line. That is, if there is a path from, if P is in epsilon closure of Q, and if there is a path from P to some R based on epsilon, you can add R also to epsilon closure of Q. Are you getting me? That is, if Q, if P is in epsilon closure of Q, then if there exists a transition from P to R on epsilon, you can add R also to epsilon closure of Q. So I'm adding 3. Now from 4 to 5, yeah, this is 8. Yeah. From 4 to 5, you can't move on epsilon. So 5 cannot be added. From 3 to 6, you can move on to epsilon. So that will also be applied to, added to epsilon closure. Now there is nothing else. So this is the epsilon closure of 1. That is, from 1 you can reach 1 on epsilon. From 1 you can reach 2 on epsilon. From 1 you can reach 3 on epsilon. From 1 you can reach 6 on epsilons, only using epsilons. Now from 1 you can reach 4 using epsilon. You can't reach 5, because you need A to reach from 4 to 5. Hence you can't reach 7 also, because in this path to travel from 1 to 7 you need an A in between. So the only states that are reachable from 1 only using epsilon are counted under epsilon closure of 1. So those states are 4 for sure, then 2, 3 and 6. Okay, are you getting me? Hope this is clear. Now we will see epsilon closure of some other state. Epsilon closure of 4. The set of 4 definitely is an epsilon closure of 4, because epsilon closure of Q contains Q itself. So 4 is an epsilon closure of 4. So for moving from 4 to 4, you don't need any string. So 4. Now to move on to 5, you need A. So nothing more is an epsilon closure of 4. Now epsilon closure of 6. 6 is definitely there. Now you can't move on to any more states using epsilon. So that's it. Now epsilon closure of 2 is there definitely. Now you can reach from 2 to 3 using epsilon, so 3. Now you can reach 6 using epsilons using 3. So 6 also is there in the epsilon closure of 2. Hope this is clear. That is how to compute epsilon closure of a state Q. Q should definitely be there in epsilon closure of Q. Now if P is in epsilon closure of Q, if there exists a transition from P to R on epsilon, then R also is there in epsilon closure of Q. Hope this is clear. Now we will see extended transition functions for epsilon NFA. We will see extended transition functions and language accepted by epsilon NFA. So we have seen extended transition functions for both NFA and DFA, right? It's almost like that. It's very much closer to the extended transition function of NFA, except for the very first step that we do, that is delta cap of Q0 comma or any state comma epsilon is equal to epsilon closure of Q0. So we have to take this extra step. Everything else is same. We have to apply this step first while finding out epsilon closure. Everything else is same as that of delta cap of NFA. Okay. Yeah, delta cap extended transition functions for NFA. Now delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon is E close of Q0. Now if we are taking strings, you know that the difference between delta cap and delta is that delta cap can process strings and states, while delta can process only an input symbol and a state, isn't it? So if W is the string XA, now delta cap of Q0 comma W, to find this you have several steps. First thing is to find out delta cap of Q0 comma X, because X is a string and A is a character. Simple, isn't it? If you haven't watched extended transition functions for DFA and NFA, please do watch that first, then your idea will be a bit more clear. Okay, so delta cap of Q0 comma X should be found out first. Let that be the set P1, P2, etc., some Pk. Now what you have to do is you have to apply this A on every P1, P2, etc., Pk. Okay. So the next step that you need to do is delta of Pi, comma A for every Pi. That is for some I is equal to 1 to K. You have to take Pi, comma A and take union of all this. Now let this be the set some R1, R2, etc., some Rj. The next thing that you need to do is apply epsilon closure to every Ri. Okay, that is apply E close of Ri, every Ri, union I is equal to 1 to j. Yeah. So these three steps should be done in order to get delta cap of Q0 comma W. At the end you will get the result. Okay, hope you understood. We will demonstrate the same with the help of an example. So for the sake of an example, I am taking the NFA that we have drawn for strings containing any number of zeros followed by any number of ones followed by any number of twos. We will take that epsilon NFA to demonstrate this. Now I want to check whether the string 0, 1, 1 will be accepted by this NFA or not. So to check the acceptance, we always take delta cap, isn't it? So we will take delta cap of Q0 is the start state, and the string that we want to check for acceptance is 0, 1, 1. So Q0, 0, 1, 1. So the first step that you need to do is you have to apply delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon. So Q0 comma epsilon is actually E close of Q0. E close of Q0 is the set Q0 itself. Q0 is there in the epsilon closure of itself. Now from Q0 you can reach Q1 with the help of epsilon, so Q1. Now from Q1 you can reach Q2 with the help of epsilon. So Q2 also, that is from Q0 you can directly reach Q2 without the help of any input symbol, because we have two paths, I mean two edges labeled with epsilon from Q0 to Q2. So Q0, Q1 and Q2 are there in epsilon brochure of Q0. Now what you have to do is you have to take the first character, that is delta gap of Q0 comma epsilon, and I'm appending this 0, Q0 comma epsilon, because epsilon 0 is equal to 0, and this is how we apply extended transition functions. So I'm taking this. So what you have to do is we have to do as per the what example shown, definition, we have to apply delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon first, and that is delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon should be done, and to that symbol you have to apply the 0, just like we have done extended transition function for NFA and DFA. And this thing, you know that as I said, Q0, Q1, Q2. So this is Q0, Q1, Q2. Now you have to apply delta of this set comma 0. So which is actually the union of delta of Q0 comma 0 union delta of Q1 comma 0 union delta of Q2 comma 0. So delta of Q0 comma 0 is Q0. So that is Q0 union delta of Q1 comma 0. Q1 comma 0 is not defined, so an null set. Delta of Q2 comma 0. Q2 comma 0 is not defined, null set. So this is actually Q0. Now at the end you have to take epsilon closure of the result. So E close of Q0 should be done. E close of Q0 is, we have found that it is Q0, Q1, Q2, isn't it? Okay. Now we have to append the next character 1, that is delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon 0. I am appending the next character in the given string 01, which is equal to delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon 0 comma this one. And you know that delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon 0 is Q0, Q1, Q2, isn't it? So delta of Q0, Q1, Q2 comma 1. Yeah. This is equivalent to delta of Q0 comma 1 union delta of Q1 comma 1 union delta of Q2 comma 1. Now delta of Q0 comma 1 is not defined, so null set. Union delta of Q1 comma 1, that is Q1 itself, union Q2 comma 1, it's not defined, so null set. So you'll get Q1. Now at the end you have to take E close of result, that is E close of Q1. E close of Q1 contains Q1 definitely. Now from Q1 you can reach Q2 on epsilon, isn't it? So Q2 is also there in E close of Q1. So Q1, Q2 is the result. Now delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon 01, the last character 1, which is equivalent to delta of delta cap of Q0 comma epsilon 01 comma 1. And this result, you know that it is delta of, and this result, this inner part is equal to Q1, Q2 from the previous result comma 1. Now delta of Q1 1 is Q1 union delta of Q2 1 is not defined, so 5. Okay, now that is equivalent to Q1, and to get the final result you have to take E close of Q1. E close of Q1 is Q1, Q2. So at the end, after processing the complete string, the set you got contain the final state also, so that the string will be accepted. This is how we find out the conclusion, reach the conclusion. Now we will formally define the language of epsilon NFA. A language of epsilon NFA some E is actually all the strings W, such that delta cap of Q0, the start state comma W, is actually an element of f or the a, the set of accepting states. Okay, that is when we process any string w, that is when we process delta cap of q0 comma string w, you will get some set of states, and that should contain that should can or I should write it as in alignment with the mathematical notation, I should write that this intersection A should not be null. Yeah, that's a better way, I think. That is delta cap of q0 comma w, you will get a set, and that set intersection the set of finite states. Here A is simply q2, so this set is q0, q1, q2, and A is the set of accepting states, that is q2, and when we take intersection, you should get it shouldn't be null. Here the set that we got is delta cap of q0 comma 0 double 1 is q1, q2, A is q2, when you take intersection you will get q2, that is the intersection is not null, so the string will be accepted by the epsilon NFA, and this is how we define the language of epsilon NFA. The definition for language is same as that of NFA. Okay, so hope you understood, and this is all in this video. In the next video we will see how we can convert an epsilon NFA into NFA. Okay, we also have conversion mechanisms for converting epsilon NFA directly into DFA. If you want a video on that, please do comment that in the comment section, because if you can also convert epsilon NFA into NFA and then NFA to DFA if you want. Otherwise, you can directly convert epsilon NFA to DFA. Okay. So, that's all. Thank you.